Name of Almighty Allah, who is the most merciful, gracious, beneficial, and the creator of all universe. So, Assalamu alaikum guys. Consistently, continuously, we are going to make the third video concerned to the toad subject. Let's move to the contents. That which topic today we are going to study. The content is topic number two, difference is tort versus contract and tort versus crime. In the previous lectures we have covered introduction to tort, difference is tort versus contract, but today in this lecture we will discuss somehow about the differences, distinction between tort and crime. So let's start. Tort versus crime. Tort is simply a violation of private right. It's assumed that actually tort is a wrongful act against whole society. But it is assumed that against crime, in tort it is assumed that when a person commits any wrongful act, a tort, that is against a private person, that's against the right of a private person. But it is not same in crime. In crime it is assumed that when a crime is committed, it is assumed that that crime is against the state. So just because of which we find in the criminal cases in the charge sheet, means the XYZ versus state. It's a versus state. But here in the tort, it's an assumption that the tort is against a private right. Then civil action is brought by the party himself. In the tort, civil action is brought by the party himself. Brought in the crime, we will discuss later in the subtopic which will come in the same video concerned to crime. Tort is a private wrong. It is an assumption that a tort is committed against any private person. For example, trespass, when a person goes without asking from owners and he goes from their into their home houses or from their lane. So this is a private wrong, not a public wrong. Then the D, wrongdoer, defendant or tortfeasor, they all are the synonyms of each other. Tortfeasor is a person who commits a tort. Wrongdoer, defendant, tortfeasor has to pay damages. Means a person who has committed the tort, he will pay the damages. But this is not same in crime. Now E, amount of compensation goes to injured party. It's a simple difference. Then the tort is a judgment law, which we have already discussed in the tort versus contract lecture. Then the nature of remedy is light. This light is not concerned with electricity, but this is light, not serious, which is not serious, which is not indictable. Nature of remedy is light, not serious, in the form of damages. Because in this mostly the compensation is given in the form of the, what we can say, payment in the money, monetary funding, monetary compensation. While in the crime there can be monetary fine, and besides it there is a serious remedy, there is a serious punishment. It can be sentenced to death and or the imprisonment forever, means the capital punishments. Let's move to the crime. A, violation of public right. The tort was violation of any private right. So violation of public right assumed to be wrong against society when a person commits crime. It means it is assumed that, simply assumed that that crime, that any that violation of right is against a society. So the punishment in crime is called the preventive punishment. Means a punishment is given to a wrongdoer and it is assumed that by giving him punishment, the people around in the society, they will learn from that punishment and they will never do the same thing. For example, murder, rape, robbery, etc. Action is conducted in the name of state, but in the tort, the action is conducted in the name of a private person. It's a public wrong. The tort was a private wrong. It's assumption that when a person commits crime, it's assumed that that wrong is against a public, that wrong is against the society, just because of which The state comes in power, the state comes in force, the state enforces the criminal acts, criminal laws. Wrongdoer is punished by the state, but in the tort, the remedies in mostly the remedies are in the form of compensation, while in the crime, the wrongdoer is punished by the state. Punishment is simply a remedy, mostly remedy in the criminal cases. Now let's move to the E. Amount of fine goes to government, but in tort, amount of compensation goes to a party, is the victim, plaintiff. F. Crimes are defined and codified, but torts are never defined, they are never codified, they are judge-made laws. Judges make the laws concerned to tort, and then the same are followed by the lower court. We must not say lower, these are the subordinate courts. Then the punishment is heavy and serious, from death to fine. There can be fine, but mostly the punishment is death and imprisonment for life imprisonment. So the punishment is very heavy, very serious punishment. So guys, here the topic ends. Tomorrow we will discuss injuria sine damnum versus damnum sine injuria, which are actually the two Latin maxims. What are these? We will discuss tomorrow. Thanks for watching. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Stay tuned. Thanks. Khuda Hafiz.